Honestly, it's way too hot outside. Hello worlds, what's up? Hope you're good. So I'm here to show you the books I read in June, but the question is actually, have I read anything this month? And the answer is yes. So this month I read only two books. So I'm just gonna show you the two books I read. First, at the very beginning of the month, I read Onyx and Ivory by Mindy Arnett. And I got this book in my Fairy Loot box, I think. So the book is just gorgeous, like with black split pages, and it's white and golden. You see the gold written? So the book itself is gorgeous. If I remember well, I give it a 5 stars. I just ate the pages. I loved it so much. So this is basically the story of Kate. She's also called Traitor Kate because her father tried to kill the king. I don't know how they call it. The king, the high king of Rhyme. And some people say Rhyme. I don't know. I say Rhyme. I hope I'm not wrong, but never mind. So she cannot do whatever she wants because she's the daughter of a traitor. So she's a traitor in some way as well. So she's a courier for the royal service. She has to go from one place to another as fast as possible. And she learned as well to fight because she's gonna have to face some night drakes. So the night drakes are dragons that only kill by night. She also has some power in her. She's a wilder and she can control animals' mind. So that's pretty amazing. So one day she will do her job, everything, and she will end up at a place where something happened, like a lot of killed people, and she will understand that the night drakes killed people, that attacked people, but it's so weird because it seems that it was done at not at night, but during the day. So that's kind of weird. And there is only one survivor, Corrin. And Corrin is actually the son of the High King. And she was in love with him when they were kids, but she swore to herself that she will never think about him again. But you know what? Fate is like always playing with us. So she found him alive. So she's gonna help him. So now, with the night drakes that we're gonna call day drakes, they're gonna go on a journey and have to put their differences apart behind them because they have to do it together. I love this book so much. I devoured it. I really enjoyed it from page one to the last one. 497 pages. I loved it. Loved it so much. I don't think it's gonna be a love story or anything. It's really about adventure, trust, finding yourself in finding yourself in a world that doesn't want you anymore because you're the daughter of a traitor, and you have to find your place. You have to claim who you are. So your name, I mean her name, is Kate, not Traitor Kate, etc., etc. I really loved it. I will definitely recommend to anyone. It's a fantasy book, if I haven't said that, but with magic and egg, obviously it's a fantasy book. But yeah, and it's gorgeous, so you won't miss anything by reading it. So then I finished a second book, so Into the Water by Paula Hawkins. It took me like 2 weeks to read it, and it's not even a huge book. It's like 353 pages. I started it for the Summer Winterton and I couldn't finish it. I don't know, I was in such a reading slump, I was not in the mood, and I end up finishing this book and I end up not liking it. I'm not gonna say that I hate it. I haven't rated it yet on Goodreads, but I'm like, I don't know if I should give it a 2 or a 3. So I'm like, I'm probably gonna go for a 2 just because I really didn't care like about any character in this story. I really didn't care what would happen. So this is a story of Jules. So her full name is Julia, but we call her Jules. The whole time she will try to figure out why her sister killed herself. I can see what the author tried to do with all the different point of views. It was supposed to be mysterious and a real thriller and everything. I didn't feel any of that. Like, I was annoyed from the beginning till the end. I'm not saying it's a bad book. It wasn't for me in some way, because usually with thousands of point of views, I don't like it when it's a short book. When it's a huge book like Game of Thrones, it's totally fine. But for a short book, it doesn't work for me usually. I didn't care if Jules would find some answers to her questions, or if she will find some other more questions. I really didn't care. Like, they could have all died together. I wouldn't even mind. And I was like, yeah, okay. I finished the book because I've never DNF'd a book and I'm not ready to do it. So I really had to finish it to really understand everything and to have like my own point of view on it, like till the end. I like the girl on the train, but this one was like, I don't know. It wasn't mysterious at all. It wasn't a thriller. I didn't feel like some urge at some point, like, ooh, what's happening? Why? Oh, maybe that's, but no. Or like, oh, he did that. Okay. Well, good for him. Like, I honestly didn't care. If you liked it, please let me know and tell me what you liked about it or what you hated about it. Maybe it was because I was in a reading slump. It was a struggle finishing this book, but yeah, I don't think I will ever be able to reread it, but never say never, right? That's it for all the books I read this month. This is gonna be a super short video for once. I hope you don't mind. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know how many books you've read, or if you've read none of them, that's okay. Don't feel bad about it. I mean, like, I was mad at myself for not being able to read, but I'm like, that's a hobby. Who cares if you read 20 books a month or zero? That's okay. You can do some other stuff like watching shows and everything, or walking your dog, or packing everything because you're moving and not watching Riverdale, right, Tommy? But yeah, thank you for watching. If you liked the video, thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and see you soon. Take care. Bye.